So where previously we'd have been using some old visualizers for showing the children's work, we developed that now with the use of iPads, so that actually we can throw the image from the iPad screen that the children are using straight onto the interactive whiteboard through the projector and through Apple TV. And that really ensures that the children can recognise at various points through the lesson how much work they've done, where their next steps for improvement are, what changes need to happen to really ensure that they are meeting the learning objective. Now with the iPads, that was really led by the principal of the school and our senior leadership team, who were looking to take that new provider on, and that's where Tribune came in, and Tribune wowed the senior leadership team with their vision of bringing into the school some of those new technologies that would really enhance the children's learning and really engage the children in some of the learning that they do. Through using cloud drives and apps, it ensures that the children are able to access that work that they've been doing in school again at home, or they're able to build on what they've learned in school by using iPads or any other Apple technology at home that seems to be so prevalent in homes nowadays as well. Where in the past the children would have been bringing in homework books, now we can find out whether they have done that homework by getting onto the cloud drive, accessing the work that the children have done, whether at home or in school, and from there we can see that it's made the process of bringing schoolwork home and homework into school a lot easier.
Great to use iPads in PE lessons. One of the main reasons is because children get to obviously film each other doing activities, so they can watch it back and they can have a little look, see if their body shape's right or whether they're doing the right activity, whether they're, for example today, whether they're bouncing it at the right height or looking at the ball or looking in front of them. It just means that they get to look back at themselves and see where they need to improve and look at good examples, rather than having to look at 30 children at the same time. We can concentrate on one video and they find out why it's good, why it's bad, and what they need to improve, really. It improves their behaviour because they get really excited about using something different in PE. You know, it's quite rare to use ICT in PE, so it's kind of putting two of their favourite subjects together and using them both at the same time. But yeah, no, they were really, really good. They really respond well, excited, you know, on task, concentrating. It's really positive for their behaviour.
At university, we were taught that ICT was important, but that it wouldn't play a massive role. But here, ICT is sort of at the forefront of most things that we do. If you can get their work up on the Apple TV and say, oh, look what so-and-so's done, they love that and they feel it's really celebrated. So it's really been brilliant. So the apps are fantastic because there are so many. I mean, there's hundreds and hundreds you can choose to download, and many of them are free as well. So it's quite nice because I can discuss with my class, what would you like to learn about? What apps would you like? Because sort of at the end of the day, 10-15 minutes, I've been using one called Puppet Pals, and the children actually become part of the class story at the end of the day. Instead of me reading them a story, we record their voices and their characters and then we play it on the Apple TV, and they find it hilarious. And things like that, you wouldn't get that from a storybook or just from showing things on a computer, because they are part of it, which is what I love about the app.
This one shows us